Okay, hi. Thank you. So up to now, you have heard the overall description of the project and the details of the developed innovative decision support tool. So this presentation is about what we did with the HERON DST outcomes and how we use them in our scenarios and why it would interest you to try it as well. Now, to begin with, this is the structure of my presentation. First, we'll see the scenarios that we could develop without HERON DST. The project developed scenarios for buildings and transport sectors for seven European countries. As a working case, I'll be using Greece building sector. And then we'll see how HERON DST outcomes enrich our scenarios and help us describe more accurately our suggested policies in order to achieve the closest to our target results, and how we evaluated those results to secure that not only will be those with the lowest target deviation, but also will have the highest acceptability. And finally, I'll share with you our general conclusions and observation after using this tool, and I'm asking for your feedback in case you're interested to try this tool. So let's start. Let's have a look on the incorporation of HERON DST outcomes into our scenarios. For your information, HERON Consortium used as energy tool the Long-Range Energy Alternative Planning System, aka LEAP. It was selected because of its user friendliness and high flexibility when it comes to available data, given that its participating country had different energy analysis and historical data. So based on the energy efficiency technological trends and policies applied in the seven European countries, the following list of scenarios was occurred, as you can see. A bow scenario and six more: efficient heating and cooling, building cell improvement, efficient appliances, lighting and bends application. In HERON case now, based we developed the bow scenario. And we also incorporated all others in a scenario called Energy Efficiency Buildings Zero. So all the aforementioned are the sub-scenarios of this one. Now, about the HERON DST contribution, we built a questionnaire, as said already, and ran a survey to collect information related with the end user's behavioral barriers. This information was transformed into numerical data through the HERON DST processing. By using this new data, we developed advanced scenarios, including different technology mixtures linked with the end user's behavioral barriers. The combination of technology mixtures was suggested also by the tool, as you have seen already. Now, after developing these new scenarios, we were ready to run them through the energy tool LEAP and get the results. So the first scenario that was developed in HERON was named Energy Efficiency Building 1, or EEB1. And it was based on the same assumptions as EEB0, only this one was taking into consideration the impact that are causing all the barriers without minimizing any of them. So, as you can understand, it was not a very happy scenario. It was more like a Cassandra. We are doomed. And then we proceeded with new kind of scenarios. So, as HERON DST suggested, a number of technologies combination that could help us minimize some of the aforementioned socio-economic and behavioral barriers, we gave it a try. And by saying a try, I mean three more scenarios. Each additional scenario adopted a different technological combination suggested by our tool to minimize the barriers and get a smaller percentage of deviation from our target. So let's see what we got for Greek buildings case. Those additional scenarios are using HERON DST suggested technology mixtures. In EEB2, the building cell improvement technology is the one used to minimize the related barriers, and the technologies that are affected with this and support this effort are the efficient cooling and the efficient appliances. In EEB3, we have the same, only instead of efficient cooling, we have efficient heating. And finally, in EEB4, we gave efficient cooling technology the main focus of minimizing related barriers and kept efficient heating and efficient appliances as affected technologies that could support the effort. Now we have our scenarios, some of them considering the end user's behavioral barriers, some dealing with them, and some other totally innocent and considering nothing and hoping for nothing. It was time for the evaluation to see what is worth keeping, proposing, and supporting. This is a quick reminder. These are the HERON developed scenarios. We have the BAU, EE0 that doesn't consider any behavioral barrier, EE1 that considers all the barriers but doesn't try to minimize any of them. It's more to underline the deviation from EE0. And then we have EE2 to 4 that provide three different minimization options using different technological mixtures. For the building sectors, the scenarios were named by adding the initial B. So we got EEB0 to 4. And relatively for transport, we used the letter T and we got EET0 to 4. So when we had all our scenarios ready and set, we gave them the go via the leap energy tool. And back in our case study now for Greece building sector, we got these results. And as you can see, we have a winner. EEB0 is, according to these results, without a doubt, the scenario with the less final energy consumption in year 2030 compared to BAU, followed by the very ambitious EEB3 and a decent B2. Yay, right? No, wait. Because we know that EEB0 got these results because it doesn't consider any barrier. And we know that the scenario with the worst results, call me EEB1, is considering all the barriers without tackling any of them. And it's okay if we know it and we have this silent gentleman agreement among us, but when it comes to reporting officially situation and suggestion, we need to present tables with data, results, numbers, and all those things that look nice on paper. And we all know that in most of the cases, the reader first looks at the graph and then maybe reads the paragraphs. So we need to conclude and present a report that the numbers by themselves can stand without any but, and it's not what you think. Plain numbers supporting themselves. So what do we do? First, we asked again ourselves what were our initial criteria. First was to incorporate the end user's behavior in the scenarios depicting of a described problem, and again, we had to present the most energy efficient scenario. Okay, we try to do this, but if by just running those scenarios and getting the best or optimum scenario, we can't get reliable results, what else can we do? Well, we can always select an evaluation method, something that would include additional criteria, which is leading us to the third question, what are the additional criteria based on the selected evaluation method? In HERON case, we selected the multi-criteria evaluation method, AMS, that is giving answer to this question by three additional sub-criteria: environmental performance, political acceptability, and feasibility of implementation. And I'm making a pause here on AMS to have a look on the selected evaluation method. I mean, after all, it's our mean to get into more reliable results from optimum scenarios to preferable ones, and we need to understand how it works. So as you can see, AMS is an integrated multi-criteria analysis method for quantitative evaluation of climate change mitigation policy instruments, and it comes with software free of disposal. I'm not going to read all of it, but if you want more information, you can see the link with the scientific paper. Now, we will focus a little bit on the first part, the set of criteria supported by sub-criteria and their weight coefficient. As said before, AMS sets three criteria, each of them having different weight coefficient: environmental performance, political acceptability, which has the highest one, and feasibility of implementation. And each criterion consists of other sub-criteria with different weight coefficients again. For example, environmental performance has those two, and political acceptability has six. Now, here it is important to see the cost efficiency that has the highest weight coefficient, which is actually nearly 50% of the overall. And this is important because we need to remember that political acceptability is the criterion with the highest weight coefficient among the three AMS criteria. And cost efficiency is the sub-criterion of political acceptability, with the highest weight coefficient among the six subcriteria. So the above make cost efficiency subcriterion one of the most important in the evaluation process. In feasibility of implementation criteria, we have no big surprises. We have three sub-criteria. So after being introduced to our new additional evaluation criteria, let's see what happens to the results of our scenarios when it comes to preferring one that we could use to achieve our target. And it is interesting to see whether the original optimum scenario is the actual preferable one or not. So this is a short reminder again for the case that we use as working example. In the Greek building sector, we got as optimum the EEB0 followed by EEB3. So let's see what performance grades they get when they are evaluated by AMS. For environmental performance, BAU is not even present and EEB0 is still the winner and the king in the north. But when we move in political acceptability, things change because after EEB2 receives a very high performance grade in the cost efficiency subcriterion, is giving to this scenario the winning place. Moving finally in feasibility implementation, we have a steadily high business as usual scenario here, which appears to be the winner of the criterion. So we can see now the overall grade of our scenario's performance. Sorry if I'm fast, I'm just trying to be on time. So this is our overall grades. You see what happened here in B2? Just by getting a very high cost efficiency performance grade is coming first in the evaluation. So we have a new winner. So what did we learn? We learned that after HERON DST outcomes incorporation into LEAP developed scenarios, we got results pointing as optimum the EEB0 scenario. However, after the evaluation of all scenarios against their environmental performance, political acceptability, and feasibility of implementation, due to its cost efficiency, the preferable scenario now is EEB2. So we can never trust a nice and easy scenario result. Anyway, all the above were implemented by HERON consortium in 7 European countries. So we have tested the tool and the evaluation methodology, the accuracy and reliability of results already in 7 cases, and we can share some thoughts with you. So as general conclusions, you may read the text, but keep this. If we want realistic scenarios, we need to add as much useful data and information as possible. By incorporating HERON DST outcomes, we managed to include the end user's behavioral bias impact in our scenarios. And this by itself might not be enough. So AMS multi-criteria evaluation method is suggested to support further the results. And preferable scenarios might not be the most obvious from the beginning, but they are those with the highest acceptability. It appeared regarding the preferable scenarios that they integrate in the greatest extent the end user's behavior and their overall performance is more effective compared to other scenarios. And finally, they contain the policy mixture that best supports the penetration of technologies in the national market. Now, this is a final reminder of HERON developed process, our pathway towards preferable scenarios from the barriers mapping to development of scenarios, the incorporation of HERON DST outcomes in them, the results, and the evaluation of scenarios and conclusion to preferable ones. As already said by my partners, you may find more information, reports on national level or HERON regional level, as we proceeded into an EU comparative analysis as well, to see whether we have common barriers at project's website. And although the project ends this month, November, we plan to host seminars on HERON DST and AMS method use in the coming years, like 2018 and 19, in Greece, and if suggested, in other countries as well. LEAP energy tool will be introduced as an option, since we all use different energy tools and softwares, and both HERON DST and AMS can be applied to any of them. So if you're interested to participate or co-organize with us such a seminar, as hosting institution, you can just send us an email or check our website for upcoming events. And here I want you to show you the website. So if you go here where it says tool, just don't click on tool, on the button on the side, you can read more about the software. I'm showing this because it was discussed earlier in the question. So here you can see where, how you ask for the software and some details, and the needs, the challenges and all this. You may find the methodology. And we also have uploaded here, yeah, we have the manual and the implementation, because we have tried in 7 different countries, so you can see here the results. And if you're interested in a particular country, you can see here our cases. Or if you're interested on an HERON or EU level, you can find it here. So that was for me, and thank you for your time.